Good afternoon, Evan. How are you today, Ken?
What a time to be alive.
Yes.
Islanders in double overtime last night.
Yeah.
Brooklyn Nets in Brooklyn tonight. The Mets stink. But you know what? It's a good time to be alive, my friend.
Yeah, it sure is. It's a positive Craigie, as you know. And it is a good time to be alive, unless you play for the Mets. Now,
yeah, then I'm you not, get hurt.
Mets fans could still wake up today. Oh, my gosh, we're still in first place somehow.
I'm not doing that anymore, by the way.
Oh, you're not? It's interesting how you're not doing that all of a sudden.
Nope.
Yeah, except if you play for the Mets, you got to look out. Because no matter what position you play, other than shortstop, you're going to get hurt.
Don't jinx that.
You're going to hurt your hammy. You're going to hurt your shoulder. You might hurt your face. You're going to
get it. I know.
It is unbelievable
right
now. And it continues. You know, it's funny. Keith Hernandez was on with us yesterday. He's like, oh, the Rockies are 2-17 on the road. And they got no problem coming here and winning.
Well, because, look, a part of me is very annoyed. A part of me looks at this roster and says, what the hell do you expect?
That is a fair point.
But the part of me that's annoyed is on Francisco Lindor and even Dominic Smith, who's not getting as much heat because he didn't sign for $300+ million. But Francisco Lindor last night in the ninth inning came up with a runner on first and one out in a one-run game. And I got a newsflash for you.
Yeah.
Carlos Estevez is not the Rockies' closer.
Yeah, but I'm sure Lindor hit a game-winning home run, cemented himself as a great Met.
That's what I was hoping for.
You mean he didn't?
No.
Wait a second. One second. You're telling me Francisco Lindor got up last night representing himself as the go-ahead and winning run.
Yes.
To steal a victory from Colorado.
Yes.
One out.
Yes.
Man on first.
Yes.
And Lindor didn't get a big hit.
Yeah.
What are you? I don't know what you're smoking, Evan, but
I don't like the smile on your face.
I find it very hard to believe.
Well, you know what? I'm getting sick and tired of this.
He's got $341 million.
You know what? I'm getting sick and tired of this because in one breath, we could talk about the injuries and we could talk about the roster and say they're not that good. All that's true. But here's the part that remains true.
Yeah.
They have a guy who is being paid to be a superstar.
Who?
Francisco Lindor.
But he's not acting like a superstar.
And right now, the New York Mets, to survive this, need this guy to perform like a superstar. He bounces into a double play in the fourth.
Double play.
He pops up in the ninth with a chance to
be a
hero.
That's a pop up to right.
And I'm not asking for that much. I'm asking for him to perform. He's hitting 190.
Yeah.
Well, and so actually, as ravaged as they are, can he step up, please?
We like to be accurate on this show. It's a hallmark of the success of this show.
What are you going
to
tell me? He's not hitting 190. It's 189.
He's actually batting 189.
Great. Thank you. I rounded off.
Listen, Mickey Mantle's not a lifetime 300 hitter. Francisco Lindor is not batting 190.
And guess what, Craig? Met fans don't give a rat's you know what about his numbers in Cleveland. That's just the reality. It's the way we are as sports fans. We don't care about what guys did elsewhere. We care about what you're doing here. And right now, they need him.
Yeah.
They need him.
You know what else they've done? And you may not agree with me. So this may be the first sports argument of the day or the week where we're kind of on polar opposites. You might agree with me. I don't see how you couldn't, but, you know, I'm going to put it out there
anyway. We'll see. What do you got?
Because of all the injuries, because of the lack of offense, because of this feeling right now of the black cloud that's sitting over the Met franchise, they've done something which, frankly, is very, very hard to do. And yet, in my opinion, they've done it. There is zero, and I mean zero, excitement or energy for the fact that DeGrom is pitching tonight.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of you probably don't even know that because he was on the 10-day IL and it was a question of what day is he coming back. The greatest pitcher in baseball is pitching tonight. And it was only 3 weeks ago that equated to an event.
Because
it's not an event tonight.
Craig, I'll give you the answer.
All right.
How many runs did the New York Mets score last night against Austin Gomber and the Colorado Rockies?
Two.
The answer is two.
Yeah, I got that
right. How many runs
did... Hold on a second. Can you guys give me a little notch in the right column? Because he asks me questions sometimes. I have no idea.
That is true.
But I got that one right.
Right.
So I'm a good start for the day.
Let's see if you can make it two in a row.
Oh,
let's see how hot you are.
Hot!
How many runs did the New York Mets score on Sunday against the Miami Marlins?
On Sunday against the Marlins?
Yes.
They did not score a lot of runs.
That's good. I'll help you out. How many did they score?
They scored one.
Okay.
Yes.
On Saturday against the Marlins, you're right.
Give me another notch.
Now, people may not realize this because we're not on TV till 4 o'clock. I wanted to help my friend out.
I don't know what you're talking about.
So I put a finger up to signify number one.
But it was the middle finger.
How many did they score Saturday?
On Saturday,
yes.
The New York Mets again did not score a lot of runs. They never do.
They scored one run. So that answers your question. The reason why you look at a night like tonight and you don't get excited, even though it is exciting, Jake is back, even though it's the undercard to the main event, which is Kevin Durant, but okay.
It doesn't feel like it.
Because they can't score runs, Craig, and we're used to the Mets not scoring for Jake, but right now we are watching a lineup every single day that's not a major league lineup.
Yeah.
And so I think that's what's dampened the enthusiasm. I know it has for me, and I love Jake, on his return that the Mets are scoring a run a game. And as great as Jake is, I mean, that's the expectation that they have to win 1-0 every night.
Brings me to my big point of the day, which we usually like to get to in the first segment. There's always an overriding big thought of the day, big
what's
part
your
of the day.
Giant thought of the day.
And you're not going to like it. You're going to poo-poo it. But I'm going to say it because I've been thinking about it.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that DeGrom was coming back and recognizing, no disrespect to the organization, they are putting a minor league team out there.
They are.
Currently. No because doubt. Of all
Tomas
the injuries.
Nito batted fifth yesterday. Jose Peraza batted sixth. That's all you need to know.
Yeah. Okay. They even went and got a minor leaguer who was batting 100. He's batting zero.
Yes. Cameron 0 for 19. I think is now 0 for, it's 0 for 19 now?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yep. 0 for 19.
And he was hitting 108 at AAA Iowa.
Well, you'd expect it to go down, it did.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, if you're batting 100 in the minors, what's the expectation for the pros?
Right.
Not more, less.
Right.
You're not going to like this, but I'm going to say
it then.
I would put Jacob DeGrom on ice. I wouldn't let him pitch.
That's a dumb comment.
I would let him pitch.
Why would you?
And here's why. Here's why. I've given this a lot of thought, and really, my thought process cannot be argued. It's infallible.
Oh, yeah.
Much like Einstein's got a theory of relativity.
Right.
They tried every which way to debunk it. They couldn't debunk it.
Yeah, go ahead.
You can't debunk this.
Oh, I'll debunk it in 13 seconds, but
every starting pitcher has, essentially, a limited number of pitches in his career. It's the nature of the beast right now. Jacob DeGrom, as we've said on this program many times before, throws the ball 100 miles per hour at an obscene rate.
Mm-hmm.
Four times more than the guy that's in second place for a number of pitches at 100 plus miles per hour. So at some point, he's going to throw his arm out. It's just going to happen. It has to happen. It's the nature of the body, okay? Why would you waste a Jacob DeGrom start with a minor league team behind him?
Mm-hmm.
When you can't win.
Okay, put the clock on. I'll debunk it in 13 seconds. You got it? You got it going?
You're wasting right. greatness.
The Mets can win 1-0. And you have a better chance of winning with Jacob DeGrom on the mound than Jordan Yamamoto, who's now on the injured list. There you go. Debunked. Done.
Not debunked.
You're conceding games. And look,
yes,
I don't have a lot of confidence.
You're going to lose a bunch of games.
Look,
But this year, it doesn't matter.
Of course it matters. Oh. Every game matters. Well, that's stupid. And you're not stupid. Your point is stupid. I want to make that clear.
I don't find
you to be stupid.
Yeah. I think Met fans agree with me on this one.
No one agrees
I
with
think
you.
You're going to find that the average Met fan saying, why am I wasting the greatest pitcher in baseball?
All right.
You might as well trade him.
Now that's okay. Now you're just getting dumber.
I mean,
not you, your point.
Go ahead.
All right. Would you agree that the New York Mets over the next month need to tread water until they get healthy?
I would say for the entire month of June.
They have to tread water.
The New York Mets have to stay relevant.
Okay. They have to tread water.
Yeah.
They have to find a way to play 500 baseball for the next
because
month.
Because if they're 10 games out, it's over.
We get it. That's why I'm making the point. Would you agree?
Yeah.
They have to tread water over the next month.
And you have to better hope that Atlanta and
or
Philly.
I'm not asking anything else. Yeah. I'm asking a simple question.
Yeah.
We'll get to Atlanta in a second.
Because if those guys start playing ball, then you're done. You're dead in the water.
Okay.
Let's get mini camps going.
Would you agree that the New York Mets have to find a way to tread water?
Yes.
And if they can play 500 ball through June, as good as I
may
think
Atlanta
is. May not be
enough, but okay.
I think it would be. I think Atlanta's the team that could take off despite some injuries in their rotation.
Sure.
I think that lineup is still fantastic. I think they could take off. But I think if the Mets played 500 ball, going into July, they'd be in it.
Do you agree with that? Yes,
oh,
I do.
Okay, great.
I think that is a very fair statement to make.
If you agree with that statement, then why would you not want to have the best pitcher on the planet every 5 days giving you a better chance of winning than anyone else who takes the mound? Yeah. Because the truth is, Craig, the way the Mets are going to win games and tread water is they're going to have to outpitch you. The way the Yankees have.
The Yankees are brilliant. Okay. The Yankees pitching staff right now is unmatched.
But they're
frankly,
not hitting.
The stuff they write Disney movies about.
Okay, all right.
Yes.
Jacob DeGrom is a Disney movie.
Yeah.
And so every 5 days.
I would sit him.
Every 5 days, you have a better chance to win with Jake on the mound.
You know what I would
Doesn't
do?
Mean they're going to win every
this
5 days.
This is what I would do. If I was the New York Mets.
Sell the team.
No. Well, they already did that.
No, you.
No. If I was the New York Mets, here's what I would do.
What's
it's very
that?
Simple.
Go ahead.
I would follow the lead of the Brooklyn Nets. That's why I'd sit my best player.
Here's the difference.
I'd sit my best player.
Craig.
When I got to the postseason, I'd bring him back.
Look, here's the beauty of baseball. And I am amped up about the Nets. As you know, I got my Nets shirt on. I'll be in Brooklyn tonight. This is the stuff you dream about. Okay? But the Nets knew the entire season they were going to go to the postseason.
Yeah, that's
the
true.
The whole
that's
season true. Was a preseason.
You know I'm teasing. I actually didn't want you to respond to that.
No, but in all seriousness, what I love about baseball is that every game matters.
Oh.
No, I really mean that. For the Yankees and for the Mets.
As opposed to the NBA, yes.
No,
because you don't have eight teams making the playoffs.
Well, yes.
I got it.
And look, every game matters. And one thing
or
you said.
Or 10 if you count the play-in tournament.
You said something a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
You said you don't scoreboard watch in April. And I said
you
to
don't.
You.
Which
you
is why
should.
When you came out and said the Mets are in first place on May 5th.
Yeah.
It was a joke.
Craig, here's why I've been proven right. If the Atlanta Braves were playing like the team we expected,
you'd be 10 games
the Mets
out.
Would be 8 games out of first place.
Yeah.
So I'll ask you again,
yeah.
Does it matter how the Braves played in April and May?
Not really.
Of course it does. The tone that I have and every Met fan has is different because they're right there. They have a chance if they can survive the next month.
So
if they were 8 games back, we'd be saying the season's over.
You would because there's no reinforcements coming.
There's no reinforcements coming and you've created
or
a hole.
Or not coming soon enough because
right.
You can make the argument Carrasco, Syndergaard, Lugo, I get it.
But they need to survive until there are reinforcements. They have been granted the luck of a division that has struggled. Where I disagree with many is I don't believe this division will struggle for long. I think there is a team, specifically the Braves, that will take off.
Right.
So I don't think being a game above 500, Craig, is going to be good enough long term.
You're playing in borrowed time is what it is. And
that's why they
fair
have to
concern.
Survive the next month.
Survive.
And one of the best ways they can survive is the way the Yankees have played. Win close games.
Well,
who gives you a chance to win close games? Jacob freaking DeGrom because he's the best pitcher on the planet.
Not every franchise can be Yankee-like now, Evan. We have something special in the Bronx. That's why we win all the time.
You're not in first place.
We are a small ball team and we need to be small ball.
Right.
We're a big ball team and we got to go big. When every other team wanted Corey Kluber, we got him. We recognize other guys weren't worth getting. They throw their arms out. Every decision we make is the right decision, other than trading Mike Tauchman. I do not agree with that. It made no sense. I don't need that lefty on this roster currently, but I do need the outfield help.
But you need someone other than Brett Gardner who can play center field.
But all the Yankees do somehow, some way, that little engine that
and
could
you know,
just keeps on winning.
But you know what bad luck the Yankees have?
What's that?
As of this moment?
I don't.
The American League East. The Tampa Bay Rays
good.
Have won 11 in a row. I mean, think about it. If you're the Mets and you're in the AL East, we'd be talking very differently about them. We'd be talking about, wow, they're out of it. But the beauty is because this division has struggled, even though I'm not confident they're going to survive the next month, I want to make that clear. I'm not. Not with this lineup and not with this shortstop underperforming. And Dom Smith, who I think should be criticized too.
Yeah, but Lindor's
he's done
got
nothing.
Cool hair.
Oh,
so
great.
You have that.
What the hell does that do for me?
I'm just letting you know.
He also plays really good defense. But you know what? He's not paid to have cool hair and play really good defense. He's paid to hit. And when you've got no one in that lineup, you need heroes and you need guys to step up. Now, let me compliment the Yankees, Craig. In 2019, they were ravaged by injuries.
Right.
Ravaged by injuries. They didn't survive. They excelled.
That's right.
So excuses, I don't want to hear them.
They're like a-holes. Everybody's got one, including the owner of the Mets, who came out yesterday on social media and said, is anyone else available to play? Would you like to play for us?
I didn't find that funny, personally.
I don't think any Met fan found it funny.
But you know what I did find funny? Tristan Jarry screwing up a minute into the second overtime and Josh Bailey saying, hey, what's up, bro? And sending in a game winner in overtime, just like he did in game one of the 19th series, one win away from round number two. I found that funny. How about you?
Yeah, no, not really.
Yeah.
We got lots to do today. 877-337-6666. If you think DeGrom should be put on ice for a while, I'd love to take that.
Nobody thinks that.
I think the majority agrees with me on
There's
that.
There's not one person who would actually think something like that.
Jake gives them
a chance to survive.
In Massapequa. Anthony, good afternoon. How are you, buddy?
Hey, good afternoon, guys. How's everything?
Good. Just out of curiosity, do you agree or disagree that the Mets should put him on ice?
Absolutely agree.
Thank you. Thank you for
that's
that.
That's ridiculous.
Here's my reasoning, and I'm on the same page with you.
Thank you.
They put out this lineup tonight. They go out there and score no runs, and DeGrom pitches a great game, doesn't give up any runs. They take him out in the seventh or eighth because they know they're not going to score any runs. Then what do you think about that?
Yeah, well,
I think it's been the same thing for the last 5 years. That's what I think about that.
Yeah. It's time to let DeGrom rest.
Can we have some, like when you take phone calls, screen them, can you make sure they can put together a coherent point? Because that's not coherent.
No, excuse you.
That's not coherent.
First of all, it's coherent is coherent. Not the word.
Yes, coherent.
Coherent.
Coherent. Coherent. Coherent. It was a joke. I was making fun of the coherency of the point.
Nobody got the joke.
It was a joke.
All right. It's like when you call him Salo, it makes my ears bleed.
I love it now.
Listen, I'll take those calls all day, and you'll see it
when
you realize.
Because they agree with a bizarre...
No.
Point that makes no sense.
Evan, it's called having your finger on the pulse of the people.
No, you have no finger on any pulse.
Met fans will react right now.
Met fans want Jacob DeGrom not to pitch.
Yes.
There is no sane Met fan other than Anthony who just figured, I don't know, I'll have some fun today on this Tuesday.
You said there's no one, I produce someone. Now you're saying there's no one else, I'll just keep producing them.
What if I put out a Twitter poll? How do you think that would go for you?
Your Twitter polls are so fugazi, I'm tired of them. But feel free to put it out. Whatever you got.
I'm not
do.
Putting it out.
Sit DeGrom. You're wasting them.
Sit DeGrom.
Every pitcher's got a limited number of innings.
That's ridiculous.
You are wasting greatness right now.
And by the way, as you and Anthony should realize, the Mets have unfortunately wasted many a Jacob DeGrom star.
Yes, that's true.
And that's unfortunate. But now all of a sudden, as you are 21-20, still clinging to first place in the NL East, every game matters because you need to find a way to survive. You want to take the guy with the 0.68 ERA and say, ah, gee golly, I'm not going to pitch him for a month.
I'll do you one better.
Top five dumbest point I've heard in the last 6 months.
Jacob DeGrom, if he's smart, goes to the Mets before the trading
deadline. And asks for a trade.
Oh,
you know what?
I've had enough. I'm him, I've had enough.
I know what's going on.
I've had enough.
Let me just say this. I know what's going on. Yeah, I'll say this quickly. Yeah. I'm too happy about the Nets. I'm too happy about the Islanders.
Yeah.
I'm too happy about life. So you decided, how do I find a way to poke them today?
Yeah.
And you're poking me. Well, guess what? The Islanders are a win away from the second round.
Good.
And the Brooklyn Nets are getting ready to dominate those soulless SOBs from Boston.
Great. And is that why you're dyeing your hair?
I'm not dyeing my hair.
We'll get to it later. Don't worry.